You build a team through a shared struggle. In rowing, there's a lot of struggle. When it's 35 degrees and raining on a Wednesday morning in January, it's like, this is now team building. We are going to make the most of this day right here, right now, and we're going to become a better team today. When it's time to focus, you focus. When it's time to communicate, you communicate. When it's time to be a leader, you're a leader.
There is an opportunity at the most high-profile university in this state and across the nation to come to this school to represent this university. Title IX impacted athletics on the University of Texas campus in a huge way.
For rowing at the NCAA level, like, we owe a lot to Title IX.
We actually started to add women's sports.
A lot of those big football schools needed a women's sport to offset those big numbers in football.
So soccer was first, softball was second, and the numbers didn't work just adding those two sports. We needed a sport with bigger participation.
And that sport was rowing.
Unfortunately, we sit right by a body of water which is perfect for rowing.
I really think it's like, if you build it, they will come, and it's really happening with women's athletics. From day one, when we took over the program as a staff, we were like, hey, we're gonna get good right away. And the kids embraced it. And from that first practice in September of 2014, we kept on getting better and better and better. By the time we got to spring 2015, that first date was flying. And they came in fourth in the country, the team came in seventh, and it was like, oh my goodness, it happened. Spring 2015, I give that team a lot of credit for really launching us into everyone understanding, not just us understanding at Texas, but maybe the country understanding what this program could turn into. And then the first time we got on the podium, came in fourth.
It's the University of Texas at Austin, and head coach Dave O'Neill.
Our freshman year, we came in fourth, and it was really cool to have the first time that we ever podiumed to be as a team. To me, like, it was almost a bit surreal being at NC's. Like, I didn't really know what was going on, and I was just like, what, like, podium? Like, okay, yeah. Going into sophomore year, I had a bit of a rough start, being ill, like, nearly losing my life. I ended up in the first eight, which was amazing. I remember when I was in hospital, Dave was like, oh yeah, you're gonna be in the first eight this year, and I was just like, no, like, what are you on?
Alex Watson, her coming back with a certain attitude and like made it clear like she was going to be a real leader by example within the team. She's amazing, you know, did some amazing things. And there was some real confidence in that last push to the finish line, knowing we had Alex Watson in the boat. We came in third as a team. We got the first eight, they got on the podium, they came in third.
It was just like every year, everybody just wanted more and more and more, and it kind of seemed like that's where we were getting. Our junior year was probably like the highlight of rowing for me. I was in the 2V and we came in second as a boat, and that was the first time that the 2V had placed on the podium ever. Just watching them come in second like made me so proud, and I think like the whole first eight we came together and were like screaming our hearts out for that second eight.
Every boat comes in second, we come in second as a team, and like, oh, and we were so close to winning the whole thing. And then 2020, like, all right, let's get going, we're on our way. And then boom, COVID hits, and everything comes to a screeching halt.
In the last 45 minutes we learned that the NCAA tournament is canceled.
We were 2 weeks away from our first race.
NCAA canceled all winter and spring championship sports, including the wildly popular Final Four tournament.
The NCAA tournament has been
no much
canceled.
Menace because of the spread.
Everything that we just worked for is gone. It was just like one of the feelings that like I never thought, like you never think like, oh, my season's just gonna be taken away from something that like is not an injury or has nothing to like directly do with the team. I really had poured my heart and soul into it, and it was just like taken away from me with like no chance to say goodbye. As a team, we do weekly Zoom meetings. So every week we were talking as a team. We were all thrown across the country, across the world within a matter of 24 hours. Making sure that we have each other's backs no matter the situation carried over into the fall for us. When they announced like you get the extra year, like there was no doubt or question that I wasn't gonna take it. I was just like, yep, I'm coming back. Like, we started something and we've only just been climbing since, and I want that national championship, and I don't want it just for me, but I want it for my team, and I want it for the people who sat in the seats before us.
Well, here we are, a year after not having a championship at all. The programs have waited 2 years to reach this moment, with the championships being held coming up at Nathan Benderson Park in Sarasota, Florida. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. I'm Will Haskett. Congratulations and best of luck to all the student athletes competing in this year's championship.
Saturday evening, I definitely didn't sleep very well. But waking up that morning, I just woke up thinking, yeah, today is the day, we're gonna do it. That morning was the first time we all got to see each other in the morning, because throughout the other days, like, our boats have been on different schedules by like an hour, just to have like the whole team seeing each other, like getting ready to go, like it hypes you up seeing everybody else hyping up. Hands on the boat and walking to the dock, like I really felt like I was prepared, like going to war.
It will be the Huskies followed by Stanford, Texas, right here.
The four raced their hearts out and they raced really well, but they came in third.
It will be Washington with the win. Stanford with open water now over Texas.
Second eight, same situation. They raced their hearts out and they came in third.
I think that race was really good, and it was really tough in a lot of ways. Like, in a way, like I felt like I let the team down for a minute. Like, oh, like we just came in third. Like, I don't even know what the four came in. Like, what if we just ruined this for the team? But I think something that's like really cool about the team is just like, no, like you did everything you could, and I know that my boat gave it their all too.
So we were like about to get into the race, like the petite final, or they were just about to leave, and then there was this massive clap of thunder.
There was like a huge crack of lightning. And so we're like, oh crap, like we gotta get off the water. But like, what about the first eight?
Because of the lightning and the storm, it was chaos, and everyone's like, get the boats off the water. Everyone run to the vans. So the first eight got off the water, they ran to the vans. They didn't know the results of the four and the second eight. And I'm like, I made a conscious decision, I'm not gonna tell them. You know, checking in with the four and the second eight at that point, they were disappointed for themselves. They felt like they let the team down. But then I'm like, there's still a chance. There's still a chance we can make this work.
Okay, like whatever happens, it's fine. Get 30 minute delay, it might be a 2 hour delay. It ended up being a 2 hour delay.
Like we see the first eight coming back into the dock. So like my initial thought was like, sit up, like keep your head up. Like we cannot let them see that like we're a little emotional about our race. We're not done until they cross the finish line.
We didn't know where the second eight had come, where the four had come. We had no idea. The 2 hour break was, it was a bit ominous. Just like sitting in the van, like watching the thunder, the rain, and just like keeping myself calm and just keeping the boat calm.
Coincidentally, our tent was right next to the University of Washington's tent. And Washington finished first in the four and finished first in the second eight. And I think in our first eight, they could sense that there was a definite confidence within the Washington team. You know, I think well-deserved confidence within the Washington team.
First eight got out of their van, they're warming up, and we get out of our van, and you know, like we're just like, we're starting to hype ourselves up too, and like seeing them get ready. And then Dave's like, all right, let's go, like hands on. And like, we start this slow clap as a team. And I, like that distinct moment, I was like, they got this. And our assistant coach Nick was like, Alexa, like the seniors, you guys carry the oars down. And like, that was really cool to just be able to like hand Watson her oar. Like, all right, this is your last race as a Longhorn and our last race together. Even though I'm not out there with you, like I'm here with you.
Alexa bringing me my oar was, I think, was just so special, because we started this journey together, even though we might be in different boats. from our freshman year to our super senior year. We were finishing this moment together.
Because of the delay, the entire team was there to send the first team out. You know, typically it would be the four would be on the water, the second eight would be on the water, the first eight would launch, and it would basically be the coaching staff and our alternate rowers would be there. So it'd be a small contingent. This was the first time all year that the first eight had the entire team cheering them off.
The whole team were like on the bank and just started screaming, like, Texas fight, Texas fight. It was the best send-off I could have ever had.
Given the stakes here, that this is just going to be a battle all the way down our track. Here
and
we go.
Ready or not, here they go. We've got a start to the grand final of Division I first eight.
I think in that race, like, there was no doubt. Like, we were behind, like, for, I don't know, like, 1,500 maybe. But I knew, like, once we'd walked through Washington, I was like, okay, we got this. Like, we can move through anybody.
But here comes Texas.
Inch by inch, they just inch in front of Stanford, inch in front of Stanford, inch in front of Stanford. And it's like, they have 250 left and Stanford is not taking this from them. Like, they have this in the bag.
I'm gonna give the advantage right now to Texas. I don't think anything can stop them. They've got their boots on and they're ready to kick it into gear.
That last 250, like, we just absolutely surged and
chasing,
then crossing that
it
line.
It is Texas for the goal. That it is a historic win here at the NCAA championship.
It was just surreal. Like, we were just like, we just won. Like, and like, they crossed that finish line and I just like fell to my knees. I was like so proud, like just so unbelievably proud. See all of the hard work pay off. And it was like, we had a chance to win. It wasn't like it was in the bag, but like everything had to fall into place and the team had to do everything that they could to get it.
I remember we pulled into like, there was like a, to get some water, there was a dock and Dave came over. We didn't know. And he came over and was just like, yeah, well done guys, well done. And then we were like, okay, where did we come? He was like,
Texas, Stanford, Washington.
Oh yeah, we came first. And we were just like, what? How? What?
Yeah, we intentionally didn't tell you.
What? Like, we just won a national championship.
We had won. And I think for me, it was just so unreal. Like, I was like, oh my god, like, so just unbelievably proud. I will never regret coming back for a fifth year. This team has so much heart and has literally poured it out every single day and all weekend long, and to see them cross the finish line and to see like all of the emotions on the rest of the team, like, it was just like a life-defining moment, as Dave would say, and a moment that I'll never forget for the rest of my life.
No time for losers, because we are the champions of the world!
To the coaches, I just want to say thank you for taking me on. I don't know where I would have been if I hadn't have come to Texas. The coaches did such an amazing job with the team, and you guys are amazing.
To all my teammates, my coaches, to the staff, Longhorn Nation, just thank you. You know, like, this has been the best 5 years of my life. These are memories I'll never forget, and everything in between from, like you guys are my family, and you are what makes rowing at Texas so special. Like, this team is so special, and I'll always bleed burnt orange, so.